ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Let's move along, please. Okay, let's move along, please. Okay. All right, huh? Let's move along. I got to start the meeting.
Thank you.
Wherever they went, we'll come get this thing. So.
Please.
Did not mean we're not closed out to discussing other delivery methods, whether it's the submarine launch or the airborne. But we thought that we should resolve this one. And we're concentrating on basically a reduction in warheads as the best outcome. And come down to an equal and a verifiable. That is very important. Just on trust. We have to have the means to verify that the other one is reducing as well as themselves. I think of immediate interest, however, would be the INF talks. And it is true, we started out, and in the depths of my heart, the ultimate goal would be complete elimination of those weapons. We knew when we started down that road that we might have to come to an interim position. Continue the negotiations, which we did. We kept waiting, thinking maybe, I think it's good negotiations, that they should maybe have been the first ones to suggest a counteroffer. Well, the only one they suggested was the zero proposal. Only it was zero for us and 167 for them. But our negotiators are going to negotiate the temp an interim basis to say, all right, let's find a number we can settle. I believe that the biggest concern of the Soviet Union, because when they discover that that is going to take place, that's when I think they may meet us in some negotiations to reduce numbers. But for them to in any way try to make deployment a condition, when we have zeros, and they have 1,350 warheads targeted on Europe, they could then negotiate forever and leave us sitting there with zero if we ever gave in saying, well, we'll delay. So I think right on schedule, they must be. More and more apparent in terms of deployment, and they will have to see that tactic